bless you. God bless you. You are listening to True Faith Radio. It's 8 o'clock in France and it's 1 o'clock in New York. And in Ghana, it's 6 o'clock. So wherever you are, your time will read to you. So our program is just started. So we are here with you. Join us as we listen and be blessed in the name of Jesus. God bless you for tuning to True Faith Radio. You are going to hear a message. We are going to continue our Tuesday message from now. So wherever you are, just prepare your heart as you are going to pray, asking God to release your heart, your soul, and your spirit, that you can be present, that he will give you understanding of his word. Begin to pray wherever you are. Begin to pray wherever you are. God, Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you for this day. Today is Tuesday. Father, we thank you for this blessed day. We are glad to see Tuesday. Father, we are glad that we are counted among the living. We are glad because we live. We are glad because you have given us the strength. We are glad because we can breathe freely. Everything you give to us is free of charge. That is why we are grateful to you, Father. Oh, we give thanks to you, Lord. Father, we give you thanks. We give you thanks. God bless you, Father. Jesus, we bless you. God, we bless you. Jesus, we bless you. Holy Ghost, we bless you for blessing the day for us. As we are going to begin our service, I'm asking for your wisdom. I'm asking for your wisdom. I'm asking for your knowledge. I'm asking for your understanding that you bear with us. You speak to our listeners and our viewers wherever they are. Touch them wherever they are. Bless them wherever they are before they leave. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for listening to our prayer in Jesus' name. We thank you. Amen and amen. God bless you for tuning to True Faith Radio and watching us in Facebook. We thank you for wherever you are. God bless you. This is the time for us. We are going to continue our studies from last week. It was last 2 weeks we started Deliverance. We started the first part, the second part, and today we are getting to the third part.
Alors la semaine, ça fait déjà deux semaines qu'on a commencé l'étude sur la délivrance, et aujourd'hui on attaque la troisième partie.
How to get demons out.
Comment faire sortir les démons?
The first part was what is demon?
La première partie était qu'est-ce que sont les démons? Qui sont les démons?
So we discovered that demons are spirits that use bodies to operate.
On a découvert que les démons étaient des esprits qui utilisaient le corps.
So the process of getting out of the demon is called deliverance.
Et le processus pour faire sortir les démons s'appelle la délivrance.
See, this is what we studied.
C'est ce qu'on étudie.
So we said they have normal marks of personality. That is, they have senses like us.
Donc, en fin de compte, les démons, ils ont les mêmes sens que nous.
So they can have a role.
Ils ont un rôle.
They have knowledge.
Et ils ont la connaissance.
Then their self-awareness.
Donc, ils ont aussi leur propre comportement.
They have some activities in our lives.
Et ils ont aussi des activités dans notre vie.
They can deceive you.
Ils peuvent vous décevoir.
They can enslave you.
Ils peuvent vous en rendre esclave.
They can torment you.
Ils peuvent vous tourmenter.
So, conclusion, they seek to ruin the men and women with morality, with physical, with mental, whatever God loves. Satan hate.
Et en fin de compte, ils essaient en fin de compte de décevoir l'être humain avec tout ce que Dieu aime et que Satan, lui, il va contre à l'encontre de ce que Dieu aime.
So, deliverance, we said, deliverance is a process of healing, restoration and growth.
Et en fin de compte, la délivrance, c'est un processus de guérison, de restauration et de faire grandir.
So, demons, you should be very careful with them.
Alors, vous devriez faire très attention avec les démons.
They can entice you.
Ils peuvent...
They can destroy you.
Ils peuvent vous détruire.
They can harm you.
Ils peuvent vous faire du mal.
Demons are not friends to human beings.
Donc les démons ne sont pas des amis aux êtres humains.
So we have to avoid them.
Avant, on devrait les éviter.
They are enemies to God.
Ce sont des ennemis de Dieu.
They are against whatever God is doing.
Les démons sont contre tout ce que Dieu fait.
And they push us against the will of God.
Et en fin de compte, ils nous poussent contre la volonté de Dieu.
That is how deliverance started.
C'est ainsi que la délivrance commence.
So the second part is how do they enter?
Et la deuxième partie, c'était comment ils entrent.
Demons can enter into a body.
Les démons peuvent entrer dans le corps.
So if you open the door for him,
donc si vous ouvrez la porte pour que les démons entrent,
he will enter.
Ils entreront.
That is why we said Judas, the devil entered Judas.
C'est pour ça dans la Bible il est écrit que le diable est entré en Judas.
Don't leave your doors open for him to enter.
Ne laissez pas les portes ouvertes pour que le diable puisse entrer.
See, even drug addicts, when occultism and drug and then false religion also help him to come in.
Alors en fin de compte, il y a plusieurs processus. Il y a les fausses religions, il y a l'occultisme, et aussi il y a aussi ceux qui visitent les diseuses de bonne aventure.
You see, sin is the principal cause for the devil to enter into our body.
Alors en fin de compte, le péché c'est en fin de compte la cause principale pour que le diable puisse entrer dans le corps.
When you sin against God, you open door for him to enter.
Quand vous péchez contre Dieu, vous ouvrez les portes pour que le diable puisse entrer.
Because you have become friends to the devil.
Parce que vous êtes devenu des amis, l'ami du diable.
So the third part we are going to deal tonight.
En fin de compte, la troisième partie que nous attaquerons ce soir.
Is how to get these demons out.
C'est comment sortir ces démons de notre corps.
They have entered into the body.
Ils sont rentrés dans le corps.
They have many ways of entering.
Il y a plusieurs façons par plusieurs façons ils rentrent.
Those who followed us, we learned a lot about that.
Ceux qui nous ont suivis depuis le début ont appris beaucoup de choses avec cela.
So negative thinking is one of them.
Alors la pensée négative est une des portes.
False religion is one of them.
Alors la religion, la fausse religion est aussi une.
Occultism is one of them.
L'occultisme c'est aussi une possibilité.
Sometimes we hear them from the family.
Et des fois on entend de la famille.
So these are the things that some of them that we can get them into our body.
Ce sont là, en fin de compte, les quelques exemples qui permettent aux démons d'entrer dans le corps.
So today we are going to read Mark chapter 3 verse 14 to 15.
Alors ce soir on va attaquer avec Marc chapitre 3 les versets 14 et 15.
We are going to begin from there.
On commence à partir du chapitre 14.
We have three places we are going to read, but it's the first part.
Alors on va essayer de lire trois versets dans la Bible, trois parties de la Bible, mais c'est la première partie celle-là.
To get a demon out.
Enfin pour faire sortir les démons.
That means we have hope. In Jesus.
Ça veut dire qu'en fin de compte, on peut dire parce qu'on a l'espoir en Jésus.
We believe in Jesus.
On croit en Jésus.
And that he has won the victory for us.
Parce qu'on croit qu'il a gagné la victoire pour nous.
That he has gained the victory for us.
Parce qu'en fin de compte, il a gagné la victoire pour nous.
So we need him.
Donc on a besoin de Jésus.
We can't do without him.
On peut rien faire sans lui.
He said we can't do without him.
Il a dit qu'on ne peut rien faire sans lui.
That is why we need him.
C'est pour cela qu'on a besoin de lui.
We're going to read how he will help us.
On va voir comment il peut nous aider.
You see, he said, all powers and authorities are given to me.
Et il dit que tous les pouvoirs et les autorités m'ont été donnés.
I say all powers and authorities are given to me.
Tous les pouvoirs et les autorités m'ont été donnés.
And he said, in my name, you would cast out demons.
Et il a dit, en mon nom, vous chasserez les démons.
So this is why we need him.
C'est pour cela qu'on a besoin de lui.
We can't cast Jesus away with anything.
We
can't cast the demon away with anything.
On ne peut pas, en fin de compte, chasser les démons quelque chose d'autre.
We can cast only in the name of Jesus.
On peut, en fin de compte, les chasser seulement avec le nom de Jésus.
Let's read Mark chapter 3, verse 14.
Alors, lisons Marc chapitre 3, versets 14 et 15.
You see, he said, and he ordained 12 that they should be with him, and that he might send them forth to preach.
Ils ont établi 12 auxquels il donna le nom d'apôtre pour qu'ils soient avec lui et pour les envoyer prêcher.
So the first part is to preach the message.
Alors la première partie est de prêcher le message.
He gives the power to preach his message.
Il a donné la la puissance pour prêcher le message.
Verse 15, and to have power to heal sicknesses.
Et en fin de compte, pour avoir la puissance aussi, le pouvoir de guérir les malades.
And to cast out devils.
Et en fin de compte, pour chasser les démons.
And to cast out devils.
Et pour chasser les démons.
So this is not only for preachers.
Ce ne sont pas seulement pour les prédicateurs.
For all of us.
Mais c'est pour chacun de nous.
If you believe in his name,
si on le croit en son nom,
he gives you the power to preach.
Il vous a donné la puissance de prêcher.
And he gives you the power to cast out demons.
Et il vous a donné aussi la puissance de chasser les démons.
This is how we need Christ.
C'est pour cela qu'on a besoin de Jésus.
He has given the power to do it.
Et parce qu'il nous a donné la puissance de le faire.
And when he was going up to heaven,
et quand Jésus partait au ciel,
he said, I'm going to send the Holy Ghost to you.
Il a dit que je vais vous envoyer le Saint-Esprit.
So wait until we have been endowed with power.
Et il a dit d'attendre jusqu'en fin de compte qu'on soit en fin de compte rempli de ce
this
pouvoir.
This is the power he was talking of.
C'est en fin de compte c'est ce pouvoir dont il parlait.
That we should wait for the power of the Holy Spirit.
Donc on doit attendre pour la puissance de cet esprit.
Because when he's sending us, we cannot go with the preaching only.
Et parce qu'en fin de compte, quand il nous envoie, on ne peut pas partir seulement avec la prédication.
He must give us power so that those people we are going to meet, some of them they are sick, some of them they have many diverse problems that we can pray for them.
Parce qu'en fin de compte, on va rencontrer des gens qui ont plusieurs problèmes et ils sont malades. Donc on peut prier, si on a la puissance, on peut prier pour eux.
So anybody who has the message has power.
Donc tous ceux qui ont le message ont aussi la puissance.
It is not separated.
Ils ne sont pas séparés.
So we are going to deal. How we are going to deal with the demon?
On va voir comment, en fin de compte, on peut faire avec
le
démon.
The person in question, the person who has the person who has the demon.
Les gens qui ont les démons, qui sont.
If you go for prayer for deliverance.
Et si vous avez les démons en vous et que vous allez pour la délivrance.
You must have confidence in the power of the name Jesus.
Vous devriez avoir la confiance et au nom de Jésus.
I say you must have confidence in the power of Jesus.
Vous devriez aussi avoir la confiance dans le nom, ce nom-là, le nom de Jésus.
That there's power in his name.
Car il y a la puissance, qu'il y a la puissance en son nom.
There's authority in his name.
Il y a l'autorité en son nom.
Since no demon is more powerful than Jesus.
Il y a aucun démon qui est plus puissant que Jésus.
You see, when the Son sets you free, then you are free indeed.
C'est pour ça qu'on dit quand puisque le Fils vous a libéré, vous êtes vraiment libéré.
So if you are going for deliverance.
Si vous allez pour la délivrance,
you must have confidence in the name of Jesus.
Vous devriez croire au nom de Jésus Christ.
Then you must know his power.
Et ainsi vous devriez connaître sa puissance.
And he will set you free.
Et il vous délivrera.
The second part is.
La deuxième partie.
You must have confidence in you.
Vous devriez aussi avoir confiance en vous.
You see, the person, there must be a cooperation between both of you.
Il devrait avoir une coopération entre la personne et vous.
The person who is to deliver you, you must have cooperation, take part cooperation indeed.
Donc la personne qui va faire la délivrance pour vous, vous devriez aussi avoir coopérer avec cette personne.
You must have confidence in him.
Vous devriez aussi avoir confiance en cette personne.
Sometimes you cannot deliver yourself.
Quelquefois, vous ne pouvez pas faire votre propre délivrance.
Somebody powerful can do it for you.
Alors, quelqu'un qui a plus de puissance peut le faire pour vous.
You see, steadily, those who are going for deliverance, they must be honest.
Alors, ceux qui vont pour la délivrance devraient être honnêtes.
You shouldn't hide anything.
Vous devriez rien cacher.
You shouldn't fear anything.
Vous devriez avoir peur de rien.
That you, maybe you suffer disgrace.
En fin de compte, peut-être que vous avez eu des disgrâces dans votre vie.
You see, fear not to suffer disgrace. Fear not.
N'ayez aucune peur.
See, things must be strictly confidential.
Alors, parce que les choses doivent rester confidentielles.
I say, things will remain confidential.
Les choses qui restent confidentielles.
We don't have to expose anybody who reveals a secret.
Parce que vous n'allez pas là pour qu'on puisse, en fin de compte, vous mettre à découvert de découvrir des secrets.
Because deliverance, you have to say many things. Whatever you are experiencing, you must speak it out.
Parce qu'en fin de compte, ne gardez aucun secret. Parce que tout ce que vous avez expérimenté, vous devez le dire.
The moment you begin to explain or bringing them out, you are exposing the demon.
Parce qu'à partir du moment que vous commencez vraiment à sortir toutes vos expériences, à sortir toutes les choses, vous commencez à exposer, mettre les démons à nu et à découvert.
This is very important.
C'est très important.
Because they are always hiding.
Parce qu'ils se cachent toujours.
That is why sometimes you may dream and see somebody's face. It's not the face you are seeing. They are always hiding. It's somebody's face they are using to disguise themselves.
Donc des fois, en fin de compte, dans des rêves, vous voyez des visages, mais c'est sûrement pas la personne, en vraiment que le visage de la personne que vous croyez voir, c'est sûrement des démons qui sont cachés derrière ce visage.
So you must be very honest whenever you are going for deliverance.
Donc quand vous allez pour la délivrance, soyez très honnête, très ouvert.
The fourth point is the person must be humble.
Alors, le point souvent, c'est que la personne doit être très humble.
Humbleness.
L'humilité.
Is one of the points that God can use for us.
C'est un des points, en fin de compte, que le Seigneur, Dieu va nous aider là-dessus.
God opposes the proud and gives grace to the humble.
Dieu fait résiste aux
God opposes the proud.
Dieu n'aime pas ceux qui sont fiers.
And give grace to the humble.
Mais par contre, il fait grâce aux humbles.
Submit yourself then to God.
Alors, il faut vous soumettre à Dieu.
Resist the devil.
Résistez au diable.
And he will flee from you.
Et il fuira loin de vous.
So humbleness is one of the strong posts for God to act in one person.
Donc l'humilité, c'est une façon en fin de compte que Dieu a pour pouvoir en fin de compte agir dans cette personne.
So if you are pride, you can never receive healing from or deliverance from anywhere.
Donc si vous venez avec votre fierté, vous pouvez pas recevoir la délivrance, quel que soit l'endroit où vous irez.
Because if you go to the man of God, you must humble yourself as if you are in front of God.
Donc quand vous allez devant l'homme de Dieu, vous devrez vous humilier comme si vous étiez devant Dieu lui-même.
Amen.
Amen.
The fifth point.
Alors la partie 5
is to get rid of all contact objects.
Alors, en fin de compte, il faut de vous débarrasser de tous ces objets un peu maléfiques.
Some people in their homes, they have idols, they have waters, they have statues, they have objects as if they are serving them as gods.
Donc, dans votre maison, vous avez des objets, que ce soit la statue ou de l'eau, quel que soit ce que vous avez, et vous les avez comme si pour vous c'était et vous les servez comme si c'était des dieux.
These objects, you are yourself, you are aware that these things, your heart are in them.
Donc, vous êtes conscient qu'en fin de compte, que ces choses que vous avez, c'est comme si votre cœur était vraiment avec ces choses, était dans ces choses.
You see, some people when they are praying or they use rosary and they put it in their neck as if there's power in the rosary.
Donc en fin de compte, il y a des gens quand ils prient, ils mettent ils prient avec des chapelets et ils utilisent comme si en fin de compte il y avait une puissance dans ces chapelets.
You see, some people you go to your homes, you may see the statue of Mary as if Jesus in the statue.
Donc quand vous allez dans certaines maisons, il y a aussi la statue de Marie. C'est comme si, en fin de compte, c'était Jésus qui était dans ces statues.
There are many objects, talismans. There are many objects that hold us in bondage.
Et il y a aussi beaucoup d'objets qui vous tiennent, qui tiennent les gens en captivité.
It can be a beast that your mother or somebody has given you a beast on your ribs or on your waist.
Et il y a aussi des choses qu'on vous donne, que soit vous mettez dans votre poignet ou autour de votre taille, comme des talismans.
You must get rid from all of them.
Vous devriez vous débarrasser de tout cela.
And the sixth point.
Et la partie 6
is forgiveness.
Et le pardon.
God must forgive you first.
Dieu doit vous pardonner d'abord.
Confession and repentance are inevitable.
Et en fin de compte, parce que la confession est inévitable.
See, Proverbs 28 was saying, if you confess our sins, see, he's faithful and he will forgive you, because God is always against those sins without forgiveness.
Donc, en fin de compte, parce que dans Proverbes 28, il dit que si vous êtes confessé vos péchés, Dieu est fidèle et juste pour vous pardonner.
Proverbs 28.
Alors, Proverbe 28,
Verse 13.
Alors, verset 13.
It's very important to read there.
C'est très important de lire cela.
Proverbs 28, verse 13.
Alors, Proverbe 28, verset 13.
C'est, he that covers his sins shall not prosper.
Celui qui méprise la parole se perd.
But he who confesses and forsakes them shall have mercy.
Mais celui qui craint le commandement est récompensé.
You see, you must have mercy.
Vous devez avoir la miséricorde.
You see, the mercy of God will come as soon as we confess our sins.
Donc la miséricorde de Dieu vient dès qu'on a confessé nos péchés.
So I'm saying forgiveness, confession and repentance are inevitable.
Donc la deliverance. Donc en fin de compte, confesser
confession and repentance.
Alors, la confession et la repentance sont inévitables en fin de compte pour la délivrance.
God must forgive you first.
Dieu doit déjà vous pardonner.
Because if he forgives you,
parce que s'il vous pardonne,
as if your sins have been forgiven.
C'est ainsi comme si vos péchés ont été pardonnés.
As if your sickness has gone.
C'est comme si vos maladies sont parties.
He releases you from the bondage you are under.
En fin de compte, il vous libère de ce fardeau.
Because sin holds us in bondage.
Parce que le péché nous tient en captivité.
So we need Jesus to forgive us.
Alors, on a besoin de Jésus pour nous pardonner.
Before we can go far.
Avant d'aller plus loin.
Some people don't know why they need deliverance.
Certaines personnes ne savent pas pourquoi elles ont besoin de la délivrance.
You don't know why you need deliverance.
Vous ne savez pas pourquoi vous avez besoin de délivrance.
Whenever deliverance is coming out from you,
dès que la délivrance vient de votre direction,
the body becomes free.
En fin de compte, le corps est libéré.
Every door that has been closed opens.
Et les portes sont ouvertes. Ouvertes ont été fermées.
Because the enemy who has been the hindrance is removed.
Parce que en fin de compte, l'ennemi qui était là a été chassé.
And then all the blessings will be released to you.
Et en fin de compte, les bénédictions vous descendront sur vous.
And you see all the doors in your life are opening.
Et vous verrez que toutes les portes qui sont dans votre vie vont s'ouvrir.
So we need to be delivered.
Donc un besoin de délivrance.
From the power of sin.
De la puissance du péché.
And then we shall be free forever.
Et en fin de compte, être libre à jamais.
See, we are giving an example of deliverance.
Donc là, on vous donne un exemple de la délivrance.
Exodus chapter 14. Luke chapter 8.
Alors, Luc chapitre 8.
Verse 1 and 2.
Versets 1 et 2.
Luke chapter 8, verse 1 and 2.
Alors, Luc chapitre 8, versets 1 et 2.
Let's read together.
Lisons ensemble.
Today, I want you to understand how we can get the demons out from our lives.
Alors ce soir, je veux que vous compreniez comment on peut faire sortir, chasser les démons de notre vie.
It is not an easy thing for man, but with God, all things are possible.
C'est avec Dieu, je vais vous dire que tout est possible.
Amen.
Amen.
So, we read Luke chapter 8, verse 1 and 2.
Luc chapitre 8, versets 1 et 2.
Luke.
Luc 8, chapitre 8, verset 1 et 2.
And it came to pass afterwards that he went through every city and village, preaching and showing the glad tidings of the kingdom of God. And the 12 were with him.
Ensuite, Jésus alla de ville en ville et de village en village. Il prêchait et annonçait la bonne nouvelle du royaume de Dieu. Les 12 l'accompagnaient.
And certain women which had been healed of evil spirits and infirmity, Mary called Magdalene, out of whom went 7 devils.
Avec quelques femmes qui avaient été guéries d'esprits mauvais et de maladies, Marie dite de Magdala, dont étaient sortis 7 démons.
You see, when we talk of demons, we take it so simply and lightly.
Quand on vous parle de démons, vous prenez ça à la légère.
He said, how many demons came out of her?
Alors, vous voyez combien de démons sont sortis d'elle?
How many?
Combien?
Hey, I want you to count it yourself. 7 devils.
Je voudrais que vous le comptiez. 7 démons sont sortis.
So at least you have 3 of them in your life.
Vous avez au moins 3 de ces démons-là. Donc,
without knowing.
Non, ne le sachant pas.
I don't think Mary knew that he had this spirit in her.
Je pensais pas que ma... Je pense que Marie ne savait pas qu'elle avait ces esprits en elle.
Except you are in a prayer, where prayer is offered, when God manifests His presence, that these demons will manifest themselves for you to know.
Donc en fin de compte, quand Dieu commence, quand tu commences à avoir la puissance de Dieu, et c'est là qu'en fin de compte que ces démons se manifestent.
Sometimes when you are in our churches and there's no prayer, the prayer is not so powerful. They remain dormant. They can relax because nothing can push them out.
Alors, dans certaines églises, quand il y a pas une prière puissante, les démons sont là, ils sont calmes et en fin de compte, ils se manifestent pas.
So these seven demons, when they saw Jesus, they came out.
Donc ces sept démons, quand ils ont vu Jésus, alors so, là, ils en sont manifestés.
If you are praying a prayer that is very powerful, these demons cannot remain there because the power of healing will bring them out.
Donc quand vous priez et que la prière est puissante, ces démons ne peuvent pas rester, il faut qu'ils sortent.
So any church that you go, you see the manifestation of the manifestation of the demons, that means the power of God is present there.
Quand vous allez dans une église et que vous voyez qu'en fin de compte qu'il y a des manifestations, ça veut dire qu'en fin de compte qu'il y a la puissance de Dieu et que ces démons-là ne peuvent pas sortir.
I'm very glad to hear churches that you don't see these things, they are dormant churches and the Spirit of God is not moving.
Donc quand vous allez dans une église et que vous voyez pas ça, ça veut dire que l'église est une église qui dort et que l'Esprit de Dieu ne se manifeste pas là.
So you must go where the power of God is, that you can see this demon manifesting, that you can be delivered there.
Donc, vous devriez fréquenter des églises où vous pouvez voir ces démons se manifester et en fin de compte, vous savez que vous pourriez être délivré dans ces églises.
That's why God said, you must, before you go to any church, you must test, he said, you should test all spirits.
Donc, c'est pour ça la parole de Dieu dit, avant d'aller dans une fréquenter une église, vous devriez...
You must go to a church where the presence of God is.
Vous devriez essayer de voir s'il y a les manifestations de des démons là-dedans et...
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I said, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Merci, Jesus.
You see, we are now, those who have come, the title for today is how to get demons out from your life.
Alors, ceux qui viennent tout juste d'ouvrir leur radio, vous devez savoir que le titre de ce message ce soir, c'est comment faire sortir les démons.
Those who are watching me from the Facebook, wherever you are listening to me, the title is how to get the demons out from your life.
Alors, si vous écoutez, vous regardez par Facebook, le titre est comment faire sortir les démons de votre corps.
It's very important to get rid of them.
Et c'est très important de se débarrasser d'eux.
They are there to disturb you and hinder all your blessings that are coming to you.
Parce qu'ils sont là en fin de compte pour vous perturber et pour en fin de compte pour garder en captivité toutes vos bénédictions.
You must fight against them.
Vous devriez combattre contre eux.
Demons are not friends for human beings.
Les démons ne sont pas des amis des êtres humains.
They always come to destroy.
Ils viennent toujours pour détruire.
So that woman where we are reading, he said verse 2. Luke chapter 8 verse 2. And certain women which has been healed of evil spirits and infirmities, Mary called Magdalene, out of whom went seven devils.
Donc en fin de compte, c'est encore là, le pasteur vient de lire encore là, le Luc chapitre 8 verset 2 avec là où la Magdala où il y a eu sept démons qui sont sortis d'elle.
See, demons are in our bodies.
Vous voyez que les démons sont dans notre corps.
They are like germs or microbes. Germs.
Ils sont comme des germes ou des microbes.
See, sometimes they don't come out until the last minute.
Des fois, ils ne sortent pas. Ils restent là jusqu'à la dernière minute.
You see, we can only see them. We can see the germ in you with only a microscope.
Alors, des fois, vous voyez quand en fin de compte, on peut découvrir les microbes, les germes. Uniquement sur le microscope.
With the normal eye, you can never see a microbe.
Bacteria.
Donc, en fin de compte, à l'œil humain, l'œil nu, vous ne pouvez pas voir les bactéries, les microbes.
So, if somebody has a demon, you can never see with the eye like that.
Donc, et si vous, c'est pareil, quand quelqu'un a un démon, vous ne pouvez pas voir à l'œil nu.
Except God open your eye.
Ah, si seulement Dieu ouvre vos yeux.
Or except where he is. Prayer is very powerful. Then you manifest themselves.
Donc ou seulement quand là où il y a la prière qui est puissante et en fin de compte il commence à se manifester.
Let's read the same Luke 8. We are reading from 26 going.
Donc toujours dans Luc 8, on va lire verset 26.
Yeah, 26 going.
à partir de verset 26.
And they arrived at the country of the Gadaren, which is over against Galilee. And when he went forth to the land, they met him out of the city a certain man which has devils long time. Listen very carefully. He has devils for long time, and were no clothes, neither abode in any house, but in tombs. You see how the demons in him, this is how they manifest. This man can never live in the house. He was always in the cemetery.
Donc, en fin de compte, le pasteur a lu à partir du verset 26, et verset 27, où, en fin de compte, un homme qui vivait dans son vêtement et qui habitait aussi dans le cimetière.
I want you to be aware of demons.
Je vais vous avertir, en fin de compte, faites attention aux démons.
How demons can get out of us.
Comment les démons peuvent sortir de nous.
Listen very carefully. Verse 28. And when he saw Jesus, he cried out. And fell down before him, and with a loud voice said, "What have I done? What have I to do with thee, Jesus, Son of God, Most High? I beseech thee, torment me not." You see, that was the only name. He saw Jesus and he submitted. That is why I was saying in the beginning that before you can deliver somebody, the person in question must believe in Jesus.
Donc, vous voyez, en fait, quand le pasteur vient de lire le verset 28, où le démon qui était en cet homme a vu Jésus, et il a crié son nom. C'est pour ça il dit que le pasteur a dit que quand, avant de faire la délivrance, vous devriez croire au nom de Jésus.
See, he said, when he saw Jesus, he said, hey, they were tormented.
Et quand ils ont vu Jésus, ils ont crié parce qu'ils étaient tourmentés.
Say, torment me not.
Parce que le démon a dit, ne me tourmentez pas.
Verse 29. For he has commanded the unclean spirit to come out from the man.
Donc, le verset 29 dit, parce que Jésus avait ordonné que l'esprit impur sortit de cet homme.
See, in the name of Jesus, we can command an unclean spirit from any person on this world.
Donc, au nom de Jésus, vous pouvez, en fin de compte, ordonner à tous les esprits impurs de sortir
he
de
He has corps. Power to deliver.
Il a la puissance de délivrer.
I said, Jesus has power to deliver.
Jésus a la puissance de délivrer.
He has power to save.
Il a la puissance de sauver.
He has power to heal.
Il a la puissance de guérir.
He has power for all human beings.
Il a la puissance pour tout autre être humain.
So, the name of Jesus has power.
Alors, le nom de Jésus a la puissance.
So he said, I give you power and authority.
Et Jésus a dit, je vous ai donné la puissance et l'autorité.
To tread over serpents and scorpions, and nothing will harm you.
Et pour, en fin de compte, pour marcher sur les serpents et les scorpions, et ils ne vous mordront pas.
So you have all.
Vous avez tout.
If you have Jesus, you have all.
Si vous avez Jésus, vous avez tout.
Jesus just prayed and cast that demon out.
Jésus a prié et en fin de compte a chassé ce démon.
So any demon in your life tonight shall be cut out in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Alors tous les démons qui sont dans votre vie ce soir doivent être chassés au nom de Jésus.
Well, today God is going to free somebody from the demonic activities in their lives.
Alors ce soir Dieu va délivrer quelqu'un des démons de l'activité démoniaque dans sa vie.
Jesus will never spare the demon in your life.
Jésus ne va jamais garder les démons dans votre vie.
As soon as the demon saw Jesus, he began to tremble.
Dès que le démon a vu Jésus, il a commencé à trembler.
Because they are afraid of him.
Parce qu'ils ont peur de lui.
They are afraid of him.
Ils ont peur de lui.
They are afraid of his name.
Ils ont peur de son nom.
Because his name has authority.
Parce que son nom a autorité.
To have a demon cast out from you.
Pour qu'un démon puisse être chassé de vous.
Only in the name of Jesus.
Seulement au nom de Jésus.
Whoever will use any name outside Jesus is false.
Tout ce qui utilise un autre nom que Jésus est la fausseté.
The deliverance will never last if it is possible.
La délivrance ne restera pas.
So be very careful.
Donc faites très attention.
When we are dealing with demons.
Quand vous essayez de chasser les démons.
You must have faith also.
Vous devriez avoir la foi.
You must have faith also.
Vous devriez aussi avoir la foi.
The person who is doing deliverance must also have faith.
Et la personne qui fait la délivrance doit aussi avoir la foi.
We are going to read this chapter for the last time.
On va lire une fois de plus ce chapitre.
Matthew 17.
Alors, Matthieu 13.
Matthew 17.
Matthieu 17, excusez-moi, Matthieu 17.
Matthew 17.
Matthieu 17.
Verse 14 to 21.
Du chapitre, à partir du chapitre 14 jusqu'au chapitre 21. À partir du verset 14 jusqu'au verset 21.
Matthew 17, 14 going.
Alors, à Matthieu 17, à partir du chapitre, verset 14 jusqu'au 21.
And when they were come to the multitude, there came to him a certain man, kneeling down to him and saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is lunatic and sore vexed. For oftentimes he falls into the fire and off into the water. And I besought him to this thy disciples, and they could not cure him. Then Jesus answered and said, O faithful and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him hither to me. And Jesus rebuked the devil, and he departed out from him, and the child was cured from that very hour. Amen. Then came the disciples to Jesus apart and said, Why could we not cast him out? Jesus said unto them, Because of your unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if you have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, you shall say to this mountain, Remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. You see, this is how Jesus was explaining. So I was explaining that without faith, you cannot hear.
Donc en fin de compte, voilà ce que Jésus peut faire, et je vous dis, sans la foi, vous ne pouvez.
You cannot deliver.
Vous pouvez pas délivrer.
You cannot save.
Vous pouvez pas sauver.
Because faith is for all.
Parce que la foi est pour tout.
Faith is a power gift.
La foi est une puissance, est un don puissant.
Before you can deliver somebody, before you can pray for a healing, you must have this gift of faith.
Avant de prier pour la guérison ou pour la délivrance, vous devriez avoir ce don de foi.
Because the gift of healing, the gift of faith, they are all power gifts.
Donc le don de la foi et le don de guérison sont des dons puissants.
And the gift of miracle, they are all power gifts.
Et don de miracle aussi est un don puissant.
You see, so if you have one, you have all.
Et si vous avez un, vous avez tout.
They work together.
Et parce qu'ils travaillent ensemble.
So if you cannot pray for deliverance, that means your faith is not enough.
Donc si vous ne pouvez pas prier pour la délivrance, ça veut dire que votre foi n'est pas suffisant.
Jesus was accusing them why they couldn't do it.
Alors Jésus les accusait en fin de compte pourquoi ils n'ont pas pu guérir.
And they were asking why we couldn't do that.
Et ils demandaient eux aussi pourquoi ils n'ont pas pu délivrer ce garçon.
They were 12, but they couldn't do that small deliverance.
Et ils étaient 12 pourtant, mais ils n'ont pas pu délivrer.
You see, power is not quantity. God needs to do anything. Power is not quantity.
Alors, en fin de compte, la puissance, c'est pas la quantité. La quantité ne veut pas dire qu'on a la puissance.
So if you have power, you have all.
Si vous avez la puissance, vous avez tout.
If you have power, you have the majority.
Si vous avez la puissance, vous avez la majorité.
So Jesus alone could heal the boy easily.
Alors Jésus seul a pu guérir cet enfant facilement.
Because the faith he has in God was so much to be healed.
Parce qu'en fin de compte, la foi que Jésus avait était suffisamment pour le faire.
The disciples they were quantity, but they couldn't do anything.
Et les disciples étaient nombreux, mais n'ont rien pu faire.
Faith is important.
La foi est très importante.
Whoever is seeking for deliverance, you must also come with faith.
Alors, si vous cherchez la délivrance, vous devez venir avec la foi.
If you pray and nothing happens, that means your faith is so little to move the mountain.
Et si vous priez que rien ne se passe, ça veut dire que votre en fin de compte votre foi est trop petite.
It's never too late. You must pray that God should increase your faith.
Il n'est pas trop tard, vous devriez prier et que, en fin de compte, Dieu va augmenter votre foi.
Faith comes by hearing,
parce que la foi vient de ce qu'on entend.
And hearing the word of God.
Et ce qu'on entend vient de la parole de Dieu.
So, you must have faith in God.
Donc vous devriez avoir la foi en Dieu.
Faith is permitting God, see, allowing God his greatness and his largeness in your life.
Parce que la foi, c'est en fin de compte la grandeur et la largeur de Dieu dans votre vie.
So, you can do all things. See, he can do all things through you for Christ who lives in you.
Parce que en fin de compte, et Dieu pourra faire tout grâce à Christ qui vit en vous.
This is the work of the Holy Spirit.
C'est le travail du Saint-Esprit.
The fruit of the Holy Ghost is faith.
Les fruits du Saint-Esprit, c'est la foi.
This is one of the fruits.
C'est un des fruits.
So if you have you have Holy Ghost, you have faith.
Si vous avez le Saint-Esprit, vous avez la foi.
Then you can be proud and say that greater is He that is in me that is in the world.
Ainsi, vous pourrez dire, en fin de compte, que plus grand est celui qui est en moi que celui qui est dans le monde.
So if you have faith in God, you don't have to be afraid of demons.
Parce que si vous avez la foi en Dieu, vous n'avez pas, vous ne devriez pas avoir peur dans les démons.
Because what is in you is more than what is in the world.
Parce que ce qui est en vous est encore plus grand que ce qui est dans le
monde. When the demon saw Jesus, he was scared and he screamed.
Et parce que vous savez, quand le démon a vu Jésus, il avait eu peur et il a commencé à crier.
Because they have seen, they saw the power in him.
Parce qu'ils ont vu la puissance qui était en Jésus.
So the demons, when they see Christians that are powerful, they also scream. And they don't know it, they are confused.
Et en fin de compte, les démons aussi, quand ils voient les chrétiens qui sont puissants, ils commencent à crier aussi.
Parce que if you have God power to deliver, you are fearless.
Donc, si vous avez la puissance de Dieu pour délivrer, vous n'avez pas peur.
Because the assurance is that it said nothing will harm you.
Parce qu'en fin de compte, l'assurance c'est que rien ne vous fera du mal.
So deliverance is done by the strong Christian, not the weak one.
Alors, la délivrance est portée par les chrétiens forts, pas par les chrétiens faibles.
Because the devil can also enter into the weaker one.
Parce qu'en fin de compte, le diable peut aussi rentrer dans ceux qui sont faibles.
I want to give an example. I was praying for somebody.
Alors, je vous donne un exemple. Je priais pour quelqu'un.
And a friend accompanied me to the place.
Et un ami m'a accompagné à cette place. À cet endroit.
He doesn't believe. He's not a strong believer.
C'est pas un chrétien vraiment assuré.
So as I was praying with that person,
alors quand je commençais à prier avec cette personne,
that my friend was holding that person for me.
Alors mon ami tenait cette personne pour moi.
So after the deliverance,
donc après la délivrance,
I said it was in the process of deliverance, the process of deliverance.
Ah, donc c'était le processus de délivrance en fait.
So the demon started entering him.
Alors le démon est entré en lui.
Then he was screaming to me.
Alors il criait.
Something is entering me.
Et il disait que quelque chose est entré en moi.
So I have to cast both demons out from them, both of them, because there was a way for the demon to enter. So I was casting the two demons out from them.
Et là, en fait, quand mon travail c'était devenu double parce qu'il fallait que je chasse le démon non seulement de la personne que j'étais venu délivrer,
so
mais aussi celui qui
m'accompagnait. I told him not to follow me again.
Et je lui ai demandé de ne plus me suivre.
He said, I will not even follow you anywhere because I don't want anything to happen to me again. You see?
Lui-même, il a dit, mais je n'ai pas l'intention de te suivre quelque part d'autre parce que je ne veux pas que ça m'arrive.
Don't try to do like the priest whose children also were going to heal and they say, I know Paul, I know Jesus, who you are.
Donc, n'essayez pas non plus de faire comme ces enfants qui les démons ont dit, je connais Paul, je connais Jésus, mais vous, qui êtes-vous?
See, you must be endowed with power.
Vous devriez être rempli de puissance. En fait.
Don't force yourself in because the devil can enter you.
N'essayez pas d'y aller, de forcer les portes parce que le diable peut entrer en vous.
They know you. They know you.
Parce qu'ils vous connaissent.
See, I know Jesus and I know Paul. And you, who are you?
Alors il avait dit au fils de Sévas, je connais Paul, je connais Jésus, mais vous, qui êtes-vous?
When a demon is manifesting,
quand le démon se manifeste,
he sees the person before him.
Il voit qui est devant lui.
He sees if we are powerful or not. He knows.
Parce que il sait si vous êtes puissant ou pas.
Before he can submit to you.
Avant de se soumettre à vous.
So be very careful those who are engaged in deliverance.
Alors ceux qui font la délivrance, faites très attention.
You must not lift your hands as you want it.
Ne levez pas votre main comme la façon comme vous voudriez.
Because you need the power.
Parce que vous avez besoin de la puissance.
See. The last thing I want to tell you.
Alors la dernière partie.
Deliverance does not close the gate of entrance of demons and must be protected.
Alors en fin de compte, la délivrance ne ferme pas définitivement la porte pour que les démons entrent.
Deliverance does not close the gate of entrance of demons and must be protected.
Alors la délivrance ne doit pas la délivrance doit être les portes en fait, après la délivrance vous devrez vous protéger en fait.
Jesus said when a demon goes out,
parce que Jésus dit quand les démons partent,
he will go and then he roam about and then come back to see if the place that he left is still empty.
Les démons, quand ils sortent, ils vont ailleurs. Et en fin de compte, au bout d'un moment, ils vont revenir pour savoir si la place qu'ils ont quittée est vide.
So, don't count deliverance as something permanent that when you do deliverance once, then you don't care again.
Alors, ne pensez pas que quand en fin de compte vous êtes délivré, c'est fini, vous allez plus, ça reviendra pas, les démons ne reviendront pas.
If you continue to live in sin, the deliverance will be in vain.
Parce que si vous êtes revenu dans le péché, la délivrance en fin de compte sera
vaine. That is why people continue to manifest all the time because they still live in their sin.
Parce que pour ça, il y a des gens qui se manifestent, il y a des manifestations tout le temps dans leur vie parce qu'ils vivent toujours dans le péché.
So we are ending here.
Donc on termine.
So I encourage those people who have demons in them.
Donc je vous encourage ceux qui je fais un appel à ceux qui ont des démons en eux.
Sometimes you don't know what is demon.
Des fois vous ne savez pas ce que c'est que les démons.
You see, Madeline has 7 demons that was cast out from her.
Vous voyez, Magdalene avait 7 démons en elle.
But you didn't mention what type of demon that went out.
Mais la Bible ne dit pas quelle sorte de démons sont sortis d'elle.
But I want to tell you some of the demons how they are.
Ben, je vais vous dire comment sont certains de ces démons.
Those people who are the genuine gossipers, see, they are gossipers.
Alors il y a des personnes, il faut toujours qu'ils parlent, qu'ils racontent des bêtises.
We have normal gossip, but some people are real gossipers.
Alors il y a des gens qui parlent un petit peu, qui font des petites cancaneries, mais il y a d'autres qui aiment bien les cancans.
Somebody was saying they are professional gossipers.
Donc il y a des gens qui sont professionnels dans les cancans.
They have been given a certificate for gossiping.
Ils ont reçu un diplôme pour les cancans, pour faire les cancans.
There's a demon behind the gossip.
Donc il y a un démon derrière les gens qui font des
cancans. So those people, even if you gossip and you send them to prison, they can never change because there's a demon behind.
Donc enfin, et quand ces gens-là, vous pouvez les envoyer en prison, mais ils changeront pas parce qu'il y a un démon qui est derrière.
Some people they can steal anything, they can go to prison. You still wonder how these things people have been stealing small things and you go to prison. You come back and you steal and go back. These people they can never stop stealing because there's a demon behind.
Après, il y a des voleurs. Vous avez quoi que vous fassiez, ils sortent de prison, ils retournent, ils volent, et ils retournent en prison, ils volent. Quand ils sortent de prison, à chaque fois qu'ils sortent de prison, ils continuent à voler. C'est parce qu'il y a un diable démon derrière
those
ça.
People, it's not prison that they need deliverance.
Ces gens-là, ils n'ont pas besoin de la prison, mais c'est de la délivrance.
The demon behind must be get out before the person can be free.
Et les démons qui sont derrière ça doivent, en fin de compte, sortir de leur corps.
Sometimes you see some women, they like men, they cannot stop womanizing. They cannot stop sleeping with men, they cannot stop it.
Et il y a certaines femmes qui peuvent pas arrêter de coucher avec n'importe qui.
You cannot sleep without that.
Ils peuvent pas dormir sans coucher
you
avec
see,
un homme.
It's normal that we have the desire for sex.
C'est normal d'avoir des désirs pour le sexe.
But some people, their desire is abnormal.
Et il y a des gens, en fin de compte, leur désir est anormal.
They can sleep with their own children.
Ils peuvent même coucher avec leurs propres enfants.
They can even sleep with her sister.
Ils peuvent coucher aussi avec leur sœur.
They can even sleep with her wife's sister.
Ils peuvent aussi coucher avec la femme de leur belle-sœur.
Some of them they can even sleep with animals.
Et certains aussi couchent avec les animaux.
So when his desire comes,
donc quand le désir vient,
he become blind.
Ils sont aveugles.
Anything that you will get, you make use of it. That is how these demons, you see those people, there are demons behind that.
Il y a toujours un démon derrière cela.
They have married and still they cannot stay alone. They must go outside.
Et certains qui sont mariés, mais il faut toujours qu'ils aillent voir ailleurs.
There are some men have married and no matter how their wife will give to them, they will still go outside.
Il y a des hommes, quel que soit ce que leur femme fera, mais ils feront, mais il faut toujours qu'ils aillent voir
there
ailleurs.
There are some women, no matter how much their men can supply them, they still lack. They have to go outside.
Et il y a aussi des femmes, c'est pareil, leurs femmes leur mari ne peuvent jamais leur satisfaire.
See, if your desire is above normal, you must go for deliverance.
Donc si vos désirs sont au-delà de la normale, il faut aller voir
le pour la délivrance. Everything is normal, everything in us is normal.
Tout ce qui est en nous est normal.
But the devil will make it abnormal in you.
Et c'est le diable qui met anormal dans
that's why people can look at you and wonder how you are behaving like that.
Et en fin de compte, ainsi les gens pourront vous regarder et voir la façon dont vous vous conduisez.
See, pride also can be a demonic, can be a demonic.
Aussi la fierté aussi c'est démoniaque.
See, many things in us that are above normal level, they are all backed by a demon.
Alors, tout ce qui est dans notre vie et qui est en fin de compte anormal, et il y a un démon qui est derrière
so
cela.
So sometimes if you see in the churches somebody when his prayer is going on, he begins to manifest, that means there's a character in him that needs to be delivered.
Donc, si vous voyez en fin de compte des manifestations dans l'église, quelqu'un qui se manifeste, sachez qu'il y a cette personne a besoin de délivrance.
They are attached to our demons are attached to our characters.
En fin de compte, les démons attaquent le caractère.
They are attached to our characters.
Ah, ils sont en fin de compte, ils sont liés, ils sont attachés à notre caractère.
You see, sometimes the demons are attached to a sickness.
En fin de compte, quelquefois les démons sont derrière, attachés à cette maladie.
So if it is a character, no matter what advice you give that person, he can never heed to that advice.
Et en fin de compte, quel que soit si c'est dans le caractère que la chose se situe, quel que soit le conseil que vous donnez à la personne, ça pourra rien faire.
That means a demon is behind that.
C'est que ça veut dire qu'il y a un démon derrière
ça. There are some sicknesses when you go to hospital, they give you treatment and it's over.
Et en fin de compte, il y a certaines maladies, quand vous allez à l'hôpital, on vous donne des médicaments et c'est terminé.
But some sicknesses, if it's backed by the demon, no medication can solve the problem.
Et en fin de compte, si des certaines maladies, si ce sont les démons qui sont derrière ça, aucun médicament ne peut vous soigner.
You need deliverance.
Vous avez besoin de délivrance.
The demon must be removed.
Les démons doivent être
before
choisis.
You can get your peace.
Avant d'avoir la paix.
You see, sometimes you meet somebody who is dumb, cannot hear.
Alors, des fois, il y a les sourds,
cannot speak.
Les muets.
Deaf and dumb spirits.
Alors, c'est l'esprit de sourds et muets.
In the Bible, we heard about deaf and dumb spirits.
Dans la Bible, on entend parler
There's no medication for dumb and deaf spirits.
Il n'y a pas. Il n'y a pas de médicament pour les sourds et les muets.
You see, except God, blindness is also a demon.
Alors, l'aveuglement aussi est un démon.
So these things need to be prayed over before the demon will go out and the person can see again.
Alors pour toutes ces maladies là, il faut qu'en fin de compte prier pour afin que les démons puissent sortir.
Before he can speak and before he can hear.
Et avant pour que ces gens puissent entendre et voir et parler à nous.
So demons can be used in diverse ways in our lives.
Parce que les démons peuvent en fin de compte marcher opérer d'une différente manière dans notre vie.
Anything in your life you want to stop cannot stop is backed by the demon.
Tout ce que vous faites dans votre vie et que vous devriez arrêter, que vous n'arrivez pas à arrêter, sachez qu'il y a un démon
derrière ça. There are many things in us we desire to stop them, by smoking, drinking, women, weed, cocaine, drugs. See, these things, fighting, these things are backed by demons. We cannot stop them except prayer.
Alors, il y a plusieurs choses dans la vie que les gens ont du mal à arrêter, comme la cigarette, par exemple, la drogue, l'alcool. Toutes ces choses-là, les gens qui aiment bien faire du mal, chercher la bagarre, toutes ces choses-là, ce sont les démons qui sont derrière.
So, whatever the enemy has entered,
quel que soit
then he meant to destroy.
Dès que l'ennemi entre, en fin de compte, c'est pour détruire.
The enemy is meant for destruction.
L'ennemi a été construit pour la destruction.
To disgrace you.
Pour votre disgrâce.
And finally to push you to hell.
Et en fin de compte, pour vous pousser vers l'enfer.
So if you have this character that is backed by the demon.
Si vous avez toutes ces choses que vous faites qui sont en fin de compte
Your end is destruction.
Et en fin de compte, la fin, ça veut dire que la fin c'est la destruction.
So
en fait.
You must help fight against every demon in your life.
Vous devriez combattre contre tous les démons qui sont dans votre
Sometimes
vie.
Sometimes when we are praying and we mention demons, people take it lightly.
Alors des fois quand on prie et qu'on commence à mentionner le nom des
they
les
démons,
they don't
know where the demons are.
Les gens le prennent légèrement et savent pas que sont les démons. En fait.
I was telling somebody you have a demon in you.
Je disais à quelqu'un tu as un démon en toi.
He began to fight me.
Il a commencé à me combattre.
So after I started praying with her.
Alors quand j'ai commencé à prier avec.
He came down.
Et
he believed what I was saying.
Il s'est calmé
you
et see, il a commencé à croire.
Sometimes
ce que
you may not sense it.
Des fois, vous le sentez pas.
Unless you meet a man of God.
À moins que vous rencontrez quelqu'un qui.
Unless you see the powerful hand of God.
À moins que vous voyez la puissance de la main de Dieu.
Unless you see the presence of God.
À moins que vous voyez la présence du Seigneur.
Before you can become aware of yourself.
Cela vous deviendrez.
So tonight, those who are listening to me and those who are watching me.
Alors ce soir, ceux qui me regardent et m'entendent,
I'm ending here.
Je termine là.
So we are going to pray seriously.
Et on va commencer à prier sérieusement.
We are going to pray seriously.
On va commencer à prier sérieusement.
Don't leave me.
Ne quittez pas.
Don't go away.
N'allez pas ailleurs.
You see, it was last week we were praying like this.
La semaine dernière, on priait comme ça.
So somebody called me and he said he was vomiting when I was praying.
Il y a quelqu'un qui a appelé pour dire qu'il vomissait pendant que le pasteur priait.
You see, prayer, God has his own way of driving people.
Alors Dieu a sa propre façon de délivrer les gens.
For God, distance is not a barrier.
Alors pour Dieu, la distance n'est pas une barrière.
No matter wherever you are.
Quel que soit l'endroit où vous vous trouvez.
If you can open your heart.
Si vous pouvez ouvrir votre cœur.
The invisible God can see you where you are.
Le Dieu invisible peut vous voir là où vous êtes.
Where I cannot reach, he can reach there.
Là où je peux pas atteindre, lui il peut atteindre.
Where I cannot go, he can go there.
Là où je peux pas aller, il peut aller.
No matter how we are praying here.
Quelle que soit la façon dont on prie ici.
And no matter the distance between you and me here.
Et quelle que soit la distance entre moi et vous.
God can still deliver.
Dieu peut toujours délivrer.
So I want you to release your heart.
Alors ouvrez votre cœur.
Tonight we have some few time to pray.
Ce soir on a un peu de temps pour prier.
We are going to pray a prayer of faith.
On va prier une prière de foi.
It's not praying in language. It's not praying on tongues.
C'est pas prier en c'est pas prier en langue.
You see, prayer of faith is one word. Out, then that person must go out.
Alors prier de foi, c'est en fin de compte quand on dit sort et ça sort.
Doesn't need so many words before the devil will leave you.
Il y a pas besoin de beaucoup de mots pour que le diable puisse sortir.
Because we read that when he saw Jesus, he began to torment. He said he began to torment and say, "Hey, what do you have to do with you immediately?"
Donc on voyait bien dans la Bible, quand le démon a vu Jésus, il a commencé à crier et il est sorti rapidement.
He has not opened his mouth and they begin to tremble.
Il n'a même pas ouvert sa bouche et ils ont commencé à trembler déjà.
That is what the power has given to us.
C'est en fin de compte cette puissance qui nous a
été
donnée.
So if we open our mouth wherever you are,
si vous ouvrez votre bouche quel que soit l'endroit où vous vous trouvez,
the demons in you, the devil in you begin to tremble.
Le démon qui est en vous commencera à trembler.
Because at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow.
Parce qu'au nom de Jésus, tout genou fléchira.
That is the authority.
C'est ça l'autorité.
Because in your mouth, you have authority.
Parce que dans votre bouche, vous avez l'autorité.
Whatever you say must come to pass.
Quel que soit ce que vous dites, doit s'accomplir.
That's why he said, I give you power and authority.
C'est pour ça qu'il a dit, je vous ai donné la puissance et l'autorité.
So we are going to pray now.
On va prier maintenant.
Wherever you are.
Quel que soit l'endroit où vous vous trouvez.
I say, wherever you are.
Quel que soit l'endroit où vous vous trouvez.
Something is bothering you.
Quelque chose vous ennuie.
You see things in your life that are not normal.
Vous voyez des choses dans votre vie qui ne sont pas normales.
Things are getting worse and worse.
Et les choses deviennent de pire en pire.
You don't know where they are coming from.
Vous ne savez même pas d'où ils viennent.
They have clothed you with something.
Ils vous ont en fin de compte recouvert de quelque chose.
God will take that cloth out of you.
Alors Dieu va vous enlever cette couverture.
I'm seeing somebody have been clothed with evil.
Alors j'ai vu que quelqu'un était en fin de compte recouvert de
cloth
mal.
Must be removed from you.
Alors cette couverture doit être enlevée de vous.
So you can pray with me.
Et ainsi, donc priez avec moi.
Any garment, spiritual garment. Say after me wherever you are. Any spiritual garment that I'm wearing. Any demonic garment. They have put on me. Any garment.
I'm putting on.
Say tonight. In the name of Jesus. Say, I remove it.
I remove it.
Wherever you are.
Remove that garment.
The garment of disgrace. The garment of setback. The garment of failure. The garment of setback. The garment of failure. The garment of setback. The garment of barrenness. The garment of poverty. That garment you are putting on. The garment of barrenness. Remove them all. It's a garment the enemy is putting on you. They have clothed you with that garment. So anywhere you go, the garment you are going with, there's nothing you can do until that garment is removed. The garment of failure, the garment of setback, the garment of poverty, the garment of setback, the garment, the enemy's garment must be removed. Wherever you are, begin to pray, remove the garment. God wants to remove the garment from you. The garment of shame, the garment of poverty,
The garment of setback. The garment of failure. The garment, that garment be removed in the name of Jesus. That garment be removed in the name of Jesus. That garment be removed in the name of Jesus. That garment be removed. That garment be removed. And the garment of poverty. And the garment of failure. And the garment of barrenness. And the garment of setback. And the garment. And the garment you have been caught with tonight. And the garment. And the garment. And the garment of poverty. Any garment, remove the garment in the name of Jesus. I remove that garment. Any garment of failure, any garment of poverty, any garment of barrenness, any garment of the devil, any garment I put it on. I remove that garment in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, any garment of setback, remove them in the name of Jesus. Any garment you are wearing, I break that garment. Be loose in the name of Jesus. 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 Be loose. 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 And set free in the name of Jesus. I remove every garment covering you. Any garment covering your destiny. That garment covering your crown. Any garment covering your future. That garment is removed. Any garment. Any garment. Garment covering your star. The garment that is covering. That is covering you. Any garment covering your destiny. Any garment covering your star. Any garment covering you. Be removed in the name of Jesus. Be removed in the name of Jesus. Be removed in the name of Jesus. Be set free wherever you are. 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 Be free. Be free in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I said there are some sicknesses. There are some sicknesses. Some people have been given sickness for life. They can't heal you, so they are given something to sustain you for life. A demon is behind that sickness. You cannot take that medication alive. You are not born with a medicine.
Amen.
You are not born to take medicine all the days of your life. The enemy will let you drink this medicine, and it will have side effects on you. And they add another sickness because they will say this is the side effect. This is they are coming in with one by one. They will add this sickness. They will come one by one. This is how they enter. We are going to bound any sickness backed by the devil. Any sickness that have been sold. Somebody, a demon was telling me, we bought this from a market. We have a market where we sell sicknesses. So I went there and bought it and put on her. That is why he's sick. And he can never recover from any medication except God will intervene. They will tell you how, they will tell the remedy. That the medication they are taking can never solve the problem except God will intervene. I'm telling you, somebody is under medication. They have been given drug for life. You don't know even when you are going to stop it. It's not normal that you carry drugs anywhere you go. We are praying that God should deliver you. Amen. That demon must get rid of you.
Yes.
You must live a free man.
Yes.
You must go with that medication. You must leave that medication. Yes. We're not born with medicine. That's not the word of God. Pray against that. Any sickness. Any sickness. Any sickness. Any sickness. Any sickness in my life. Any sickness in my life that the enemy is behind. That the enemy is behind. If you have small headache, you take paracetamol and it will go. But there are some sickness, there are some headache, it has come to live. The headache has come to live. Every time you have that headache will pain you and pain you and pain you. A demon is behind. A demon, that is why you must pray against every demon in your life. A demon is behind any sickness. A demon, any demon behind my sickness. Any demon behind my sickness. There's a sickness, it's only you. You cannot even open your mouth and tell anybody about the sickness. You feel shy. You feel shy to mention your sickness. Only the doctor knows your sickness. You see, the enemy has put that thing to make you people disgrace. That sickness is a disgrace sickness. A disgrace sickness. You cannot even open your mouth and tell people about the sickness. That sickness tonight. That sickness tonight. Any hidden sickness. Any shameful sickness that they have sold to you tonight. Be separated in the name of Jesus. Any sickness attached to your life. Any sickness that is tormenting you. any sickness that gave you headache, any sickness that had come to stay, you remove him from your office. You are time as a spy. You are time as a spy. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, tonight, in the name of Jesus, every sickness that has come to stay, every sickness that has come to stay, I command you out. I command you out. I command you out. Out. I command you out. Be separated. You sickness. You sickness. Every sickness in your blood. Every sickness in your system. Every sickness in your body. Every sickness in the bones. Every sickness where they came from. I command them out. 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 I command them out.
Jesus. You see, some people, the enemy is using something to connect you to himself. So you have been attached. But tonight, God is going to break the chain.
Amen.
Every chain that is broken tonight,
Jesus.
You're going to break the chain yourself.
Amen.
You shall be free indeed.
Amen.
The Son will set you free tonight indeed.
Amen.
He said, go and loose him. And let him go. Tonight, God is going to lose somebody.
Amen.
And you go free
in without paying.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say whatever,
whatever
the enemy
is using
to connect me
to himself. To himself.
So tonight.
Tonight.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I disconnect myself.
Begin
to disconnect myself.
Begin
to disconnect myself. Disconnect yourself from any connection. Disconnect yourself. Begin to disconnect yourself from any connection. You have been connected. Tonight I've been disconnected. I disconnected. I disconnect myself. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I disconnect myself. You fibroids, I disconnect myself. You diabetes, you fibroids. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, I command fire. I command fire. In the name of Jesus, I disconnect myself. From the power of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
Jesus. In Jesus' name. There's something that make me run into your presence, my helper. We are going to pray. We are going to pray. I'm seeing something. There's a satellite. This always God tells me to do that. Somebody is always located with the devil satellite.
So whatever you are doing, they have the video in their home. There's a satellite, they have positioned somewhere.
Jesus.
You cannot see it with the eye, except God. God wants to intervene for somebody tonight.
Amen.
God is going to intervene for somebody tonight.
Amen.
That satellite, he's going to put it off.
In the name.
It will never function in your, it will never function again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is your intervention. Tonight, God is going to deal with them.
Amen.
They will see you no more.
Amen.
And they will hear from you no more.
Amen.
Because all the conversation in your room, they hear.
Jesus.
Whatever you are doing in your, with your, in your bedroom, they are, they are only watching it live somewhere. You think you are close your door, but I'm telling you, your door is whether you open it for everyone to see. God, they see your nakedness. They see everything. There's no secret between them. Tonight, whenever you are fighting in the house, that is their joy. They rejoice over that. They will rejoice over tonight. They will see you. Say the Egyptians that you see tonight. The Egyptians that you see. God has promised you shall see them no more.
Amen.
They will see you no more.
Amen.
They will see you no more.
Amen.
Say any satellite,
any satellite,
the enemy
using
to locate me. Say tonight. Say
tonight.
Anywhere they are. Say I command the Holy Ghost fire.
I command the Holy Ghost fire
to disconnect that.
To disconnect their heart.
Disconnect them. They say, when you disconnect them, it won't function. There will be no light for them. Their screen will not function again. God is going to disconnect for you. I disconnect any satellite. Any satellite they are using against me. I disconnect the satellite. They will see you no more. They will hear you no more. They will not hear you anymore. Whatever they are using to take over you, to locate you, to watch their video, to watch my life, to watch my nakedness. Tonight I disconnect them. Tonight I disconnect them. In the name of Jesus. There somebody have accepted a contract concerning you. This year, they have paid somebody. There's a contract, a big contract. The person has accepted. It has been paid. So somebody has accepted a contract concerning you and your family. So we are going to pray tonight that the Holy Ghost fire will deal with them.
Amen.
And not only that, God is going to expose them.
Amen.
They are coming as friends. They are coming as brothers. They are hiding. I'm telling you tonight, you are watching the Facebook, but tonight, God will give you the heart book.
Yes, amen.
I'm telling you tonight, God will open their heart to you.
Amen.
So you have the heart book in front of you.
Amen.
You have the Facebook and you have the heart book. You fear less because you know what is going on.
Amen.
Tonight, that is your prayer. Whoever has accepted a contract concerning me.
Whoever has accepted a contract concerning me and my family, tonight.
I command the Holy Ghost fire. Command fire against them. In the contract this year. Whoever has accepted a contract concerning me this year. I come against them.
In the name of Jesus.
See, some people, the enemy always will visit you when you are at sleep. That is when he will see your weakness. Jesus. When you are asleep, you are helpless. So they only come at that time to disturb you. Tonight, any demon assigned to your dreams, at times you see them wanting to have affair with you. You will see them in many ways. Sometimes you see many different faces. They will come like animal. They can change yourself because demons can change yourself as they want to deceive you. You know the person, but the demon is behind. I want to tell you, anytime you see anybody in your dream, don't think that the person is there physical. The demon is hiding, is putting somebody's face, and it's coming to you. God will expose them. Say tonight.
Tonight.
Say tonight.
Tonight.
Any demon. Assigned to my dream.
Assigned to my dream.
Say, any demon.
Any demon.
Assigned to my dream.
Assigned to my dream.
Say tonight.
Tonight.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I command fire.
I command fire.
I command fire.
I command fire.
Holy Ghost 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 fire. Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Holy
Ghost fire.
Fire. Fire.
Fire.
Fire.
Fire.
Fire.
Fire.
Fire.
Fire.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost
fire. Holy Ghost
fire.
Fire. Holy Ghost
fire.
Holy Ghost
fire.
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 Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
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 Holy Ghost
fire.
Holy Ghost
fire.
Fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
In the name of Jesus.
Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost
fire. Oh, hallelujah.
The only thing the devil is afraid is the fire of the Holy Ghost and the blood.
Amen.
You are going to cover yourself with the blood, your whole family. Amen. You are going to cover your whole family with the blood tonight.
Amen.
It's time to go to sleep. When you are covered with the blood, he said, when they see the blood, they will pass over.
Amen.
That will be your Passover tonight. Amen. You are praying and soaking your house, your household, and yourself in the blood. Begin to soak yourself now. Begin to soak the whole family. The enemy can never use their faces to do evil. The enemy can never come to your house and remove any of the faces there for evil. That people may see you and be hating you. People, somebody will see you and you hate him because they have seen your face. They are using somebody's face as a cover. The enemy is using somebody's face as a cover. Begin to cast the demon out. Begin to cast them out. Soak yourself, soak yourself, soak yourself, soak yourself. The blood will speak for you. 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 In the name of Jesus. The blood will speak for you. 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 In the name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In
Jesus' name.
Mighty precious.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be covered with the blood.
Blood of Jesus.
My viewers, I'm praying for you. Be covered with the blood.
Blood of Jesus.
Be covered with the blood.
Amen.
Be covered with the blood.
Amen.
Be sanctified with the blood.
Amen.
Be purified with the blood.
Amen.
Be clean with the blood.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be covered.
Amen.
Be covered.
Amen.
Be covered.
Amen.
May the blood speak for you tonight.
Jesus.
The blood be a mark on your wall.
Jesus.
On your house.
Yes.
On your forehead.
Amen.
On your doorstep.
Amen.
On your doorstep.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every demon
Jesus.
Who will see this blood
Jesus.
Will pass over.
Jesus.
Every demon
Jesus.
Who come to your house tonight
Jesus.
Will pass
Jesus.
Over.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I come against any
Jesus.
Weapon
Jesus.
That fashion against you tonight.
Amen.
This year, any weapon they have sent, I send to the tender in the name of Jesus. We return to the sender in the name of Jesus. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Any weapon fashioned against you shall never prosper in the name of Jesus. I remove every spiritual garment you are wearing in the name of Jesus. Every spiritual garment, you are wearing, I remove them in the name of Jesus. Every garment, I remove them. Every garment,
Jesus.
I remove them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever the enemy is connecting you with,
Jesus.
I disconnect you tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever the enemy is using to connect you to himself, I disconnect you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I disconnect you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command every sickness that is the enemy is behind. I command you to be healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command that demon out.
Amen.
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 In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever satellite,
Holy Ghost,
they are using to connect
Jesus.
Any satellite,
Lord of
I say any satellite, they are using to connect you.
Jesus.
Anywhere they are. I disconnect you in the name of
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
They will see you no more.
Amen.
I said they will see you no more.
Amen.
From tonight, I disconnect you.
Amen.
I disconnect you.
Amen.
I disconnect you.
Amen.
I disconnect you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every barren.
Jesus.
There's a curse.
Yes.
They have pronounced in your family.
Yeah.
It's barrenness.
Mm. Jesus.
I command that badness to quit you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, any demon of badness in me.
Any demon of barrenness
be cast out in the name of Jesus.
Cast out in Jesus' name.
I cast you out. I cast you out. I cast you out. You demon of barrenness. Every demon of barrenness. Be cast out. Be cast out. Be cast out. Be cast out. Receive your womb. Receive your womb. Be cast out. Be cast out. Be cast out. Be cast out. In Jesus' name. Any fibroid attached to your womb.
Yes.
Any fibroid attached to your womb.
Yes.
I disconnect the fibroid in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be separated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be separated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be separated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You demon of fibroid.
Jesus.
I command you out.
Amen.
I command you out.
Jesus.
I command you out.
Jesus.
I command you out.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be free from fibroid.
In the name of Jesus.
May that fibroid disappear from you in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
For healing your children.
Amen.
I thank you.
Amen.
For saving them.
Amen.
I thank you.
Amen.
For bringing deliverance tonight.
Amen.
I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
That you have restored them.
Amen.
I thank you.
Yes, Lord.
For removing their disgrace.
Amen.
I thank you.
Yes, Lord.
For restoring their womb.
Amen.
That God will be productive.
Amen.
And give their testimonies.
Yes.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
God bless you all.
God bless you.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus.
Tomorrow is under day. So the numbers, the lines, the telephone lines are on the screen. Those who are watching on the YouTube, Facebook, you can see our numbers passing under the screen. If you need any help, don't hesitate to call. We are there for you. Anything that is bothering you, there are certain things that are a secret. I'm telling you, here we keep confidentiality. Things are confidential. We shall never expose you.
Amen.
Believe God.
Amen.
We shall never expose you.
Amen.
Because God is in the midst.
Mm-hmm.
Of whatever we are doing, and he will never expose you.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have any problem that the doctor have said they can do nothing to it, we have somebody more than them.
Amen.
Dr. Jesus can do any sickness.
Amen.
In you.
Amen.
So I encourage you to call. If you have any place they do deliverance, I will advise you to go there. But if you don't have any place to go, you can call here and then we can pray with you online. Or if it's necessary, you come down wherever you are. We ask you to come down here, then we pray together. Before you can get your freedom, don't feel shy. Don't feel shy. Don't hide that sickness. Don't hide the problem.
Amen.
If not, the devil is using that against you to feel shy so that he keep you for long. Please, don't worry. If you have had terrible dreams that you don't understand, some people they dream, they don't care. Some people they dream, they don't know what to do. If something is beyond your control, you call us. We can explain to you what the dream is. We can pray over whatever the devil. God always speaks to us in our dreams.
Yes.
God always speaks to us in our dreams.
Amen.
Don't neglect dreams.
Yeah.
Don't take dreams lightly.
Amen.
God is speaking to you. Whether it is bad or good dream, God is still behind. He's just showing you what is going on in your life.
Mm.
That is why Joseph could see his whole life in a dream. He saw what he's going to do, what God is going to use him for. He saw that in a twinkling of a dream. So God will show you something, either good or bad. You must bring it out. If you don't know how to interpret them, God can help us to interpret your dream, and then we can bound or we can lose whatever God has permitted us to do. So don't hesitate to call here if you have any trouble. We are waiting for your call. I will leave here at 10 o'clock. So if you have anything to call, you can call me. We can hear you, and then we can share whatever you have. And then we pray over. So tomorrow is Wednesday. If God permits, tomorrow also is a prayer night. Tomorrow is not teachings. It is nothing. It's prayer. Every Wednesday is prayer. So tomorrow, if you are coming, you prepare your heart because you are going to enter into prayer.
Amen.
Long prayer. Prayer of that season. Say, pray of that season, my brother. It's not a time to sleep. It's not a time to watch television. It's not a time to work to watch Nigeria films. It's not a time to go to disco. It's not a time to go to beer bar. It's not a time to go to cafe bar. It's not a time to visit friends. It's time for prayer. Tomorrow from 8 o'clock, it's time for prayer. Please come and join hands, because this year we have to destroy the work of the devil. It's only through prayer we can destroy. It's only through prayer
Amen.
We can do them. We are going to untie the hands of God to release our blessing this year, because the devil is at work and God will deal with us. Without prayer, God will never work. Encourage yourself that if I don't pray, God will never work. So your prayer will put God to work. So I encourage you tomorrow, come and join us together and pray. Tomorrow, our topic for tomorrow was last 2 weeks we started. It said 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 to 4. It said we should pray for all men. We should pray for all men. If you read there, you're going to know what after. So tomorrow, everybody on earth needs prayer. So you're going to select the type of people that God wants us to pray for that particular tomorrow. So pray tomorrow. If God permits, we are still alive. We'll be here and pray together and destroy the work of the devil. Our prayer will destroy the work of the devil.
Amen.
So God will be with us.
Amen.
So God bless you wherever you are. May he cover you.
Amen.
All my listeners, my viewers, God bless you all.
Amen.
I have some few names that I can mention because I cannot mention them all. So if you don't hear your name, don't worry, because sometimes I don't find them here. I find them somewhere, so I cannot go everywhere. So Akwasi, you are welcome. My own Akwasi, you are welcome. Thank you, Akwasi, for being with us. My brother Ejakon, also in Ghana, thank you very much for tuning into Happy. Thank you, Happy Peters. Thank you for being with us. Mr. Usu, I thank you. Saturday, I will meet you here. Don't forget. Jennifer, God bless you. God bless you. You have been listening to me always. God bless you, Jennifer. God bless you. God bless you. Santua, God bless you wherever you are. God bless you. Akosia Pokuya, God bless you wherever you are. God bless you. Tina, God bless you. Thank you very much for listening and watching us. God bless you. I cannot mention all, so whoever I cannot mention, God bless you wherever you are. Catherine, God bless you. Some of them have gone over. So thank you very much for watching. God bless you all. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You are still waiting for your calls if there's a need. Don't hesitate. Come and we shall pray with you. God bless you again.
Dernier avec le pasteur Romain Croton.
Ouais.
Ça a coupé, j'ai dit pourquoi ça a coupé.
Tu as touché quelque chose?
Non. Non, non. Ça s'est coupé. Ça fait,
Mais par contre.